Yeah, I'm gonna take my horse to the old town road. I'm gonna ride till I can't no more. I'm gonna take my horse to the old town road. I'm gonna ride till I can't no more.
I got the horses in the back, horse stock is attached. Head is matted black, got the bushes black to match. Riding on a horse, ha, you can whip your Porsche.
What's up, fishy friends? This is Seabass here. Hope all you guys are having a wonderful and awesome day today. I know I am, because we are going halibut fishing! Halibut fishing, yes! Oh my god, I'm super excited. I've been waiting for this trip for a very long time. We're finally here. It is Wednesday, May 8th. We're here at Neah Bay, out on the Olympic Peninsula, at Cape Resort. So, all with us, we have Uncle Ronny back there. And then we also have my papa's longtime friend, Kevin, again. And then my papa and then myself. Kevin, he brought his humongous trailer for us to stay in, and then Papa brought the boat. So we're gonna be staying in Kevin's trailer and then popping out the next day to go fishing, but super excited for this trip. Can't wait to catch my first ever halibut. It's gonna be good. So Papa right now is just getting everything finalized and ready. And then we'll get everything situated and see what we'll do for the rest of the day, but we're here. So we're over here at camp, just got the RV all set up, got all the hose connected, got all the power and stuff, got all the pullouts pulled out. But right now we are going to go look at the boat launch and see if we can try to launch the boat right now, so then we don't have to do it later. It is low tide, so if it is high enough to where we can launch it, then we could launch it right now. Otherwise, we just gotta wait until high tide comes back and then we'll launch it. But let's take a little tour of the trailer real fast. It is a Freedom Livery Express.
Oh yeah, look at this. Can you sit down?
Hell yeah.
Holy sit down, smacking
your knees on it.
I'm gonna turn on light. And a flat screen TV.
It's roomy in here. Holy cow.
27 foot.
27 foot?
Same length as a boat. If we could put this inside my boat, we'd be doing good.
We got a bed over here.
Technology. Bet you the slide outs make a big difference.
Huge. Yeah. Bathroom.
Slide out was half that size. It went out half that. It was half.
Couch. This is awesome. Alright guys, so we just checked out the boat launch. Tide is coming up right now. My papa thinks that we will be able to launch it probably in about 15-30 minutes. They're going down there right now. I am walking over there. It's a nice beautiful sunny day out here in Neah Bay. The wind isn't too windy. It seems like it's pretty calm out there too. do see a couple white cap rollers, but that's nothing really. All right, let's go, buddies. All right, we're over here at the boat launch. We have this humongous boat, 26-foot Pro Cuddy Riverhawk, trying to launch with twin 200 Yamahas. Trying to launch the boat. If they make it, then we can make it, and then we can launch the boat, and we'll be good. So. Well, he got it in the water somehow. I don't know how, but he did it. Good job, for real. There was a sea lion right there. Yeah. 6 feet, probably a 23-foot river wild. All the way here in Washington. All right, so we're launching the boat right now. We have Bob's Sporting Goods boat back there. But tide has come up. There's about, I don't know, five or so boats that launched before us that successfully made it. Some of them scraped the bottom of the boat ramp, but they were okay in the end. All right, just a moment of truth. All right, me and Kevin here are at this little wash station that's right here, right next to the boat launch, to wash out the boat real fast so all the salt water doesn't seep into everything. So it's all fresh and sparkly. Then we will go park the trailer back at camp, and then we will meet Papa at D25, which is over there where we're mooring the boat at. And then after that, we are going to catch some sea bass. Oh, we're gonna catch myself. Oh my God, we are going sea bass fishing. Yeah. Ta-da.
Oh no, I'm good.
I brought the pepperoni.
Yeah, all right.
All right, we're off to catch some sea bass.
Ride till I can't no more. Hat down, cross town, living like a rock star. Spend a lot of money on my brand new guitar. Baby's got a habit, diamond rings and Fendi sports bras. Riding down Rodeo in my Maserati sports car. Got no stress, I've been through all that. I'm like a Marlboro man.
here at our Seabass spot. It was a pretty nice ride out here. Probably about half an hour. Let's get the fish in here. So, see, we're using little, I think half ounce jig head with a little tiny grub tail. All right, let's get to fishing. Switch over to the GoPro. Pew.
I got a fish tail. Woo! Oh no, he came off.
Two fish of the day, Uncle Ronnie and Papa. Okay, chill. Stay there.
Yeah, finally. I didn't get it out of the hook set, but.
Oh, look at that.
He broke off.
See that? I got a net right underneath with me.
Come on, baby. I got one of them.
Keep in the water.
You get the jig out?
Yeah.
You get the jig out? Had that one fish?
Who's yours?
Yeah.
Oh.
It was
snapped your line?
Yeah, I snapped my line.
Oh, I didn't know that. I thought you floated in the water, it floated away.
Let me check, let me check. Where's all your jigs at? Jig heads? Camera was on for half of it.
Huh?
It was on for half of it.
On right now?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah. That's a nice one.
I had a few choice words for this lure that I just got. That's a thing.
Oh, they're thick down there. My God. No, my God.
Yeah.
Oh, he came off. Oh, he took my freaking paddle tail. Right there, flies right there.
Got off. Cool. You recording?
It's okay.
Man, that one was tough. You didn't want to take it.
There we go. Baby Linkard. We are almost at our limit. We have two more fish to go. I am halfway seasick ish. I don't know. Whoa. There's a couple other boats out there. There's a long lining boat over there. Otherwise, we were in a school of fish. All right, so we're back home, away from the open ocean. Oh, it's a crazy experience for me. You know, we started catching fish, and then we had the two fish left, and then we got into a nice school, and then caught the last two fish. Probably caught a linkod, a little tiny linkod. But we got our 24 fish. It's a 6 fish limit per person. 6 times 4 is 24. Pretty nice size. Really nice size, actually. And I'm sorry if I couldn't get enough video. I was on the phone, actually, because I was like, oh, and then it's hard because the waves were like, oh, it's. And then I was starting to feel in it after that because some big rollers are starting to come in, and I was like, oh, okay. But we're back and we have a whole bunch of fish.
Need a new bucket. That just like totally ripped off.
Yeah, this thing is.
Yeah.
It's all fatigued out with the salt water.
That's all the fishies.
About 3 to 4 pound sea bass.
Uh-huh. Some nice sea bass here at Neah Bay. Woo! Awesome. Alrighty, peeps, it's fillet time.
You don't want the bones.
So we're on our way back to camp. Just got the boat all ready for tomorrow. Cleaned all up, washed it off. Cleaned all the fish. Fish is in a bucket, soaking a little bit of water so I can get some of the nasty fishy stuff off. Go back to camp. No, there's a whole bunch of them. There's a whole bunch of them along the dock. There's a whole bunch of them. There's like one right there and then one over there. See, there's one right there too. And Kevin is back at camp making dinner.
All ready to go halibut fishing tomorrow. Bright and early. God, some of these boats are insane.
Childproof something fucking ranch. Jesus.
What's up, fishy friends? This is the first official day of halibut fishing at Neah Bay. We're here inside the trailer. We just put everything away. It is currently 5:25 a.m. Some of us just had breakfast. I got hot cocoa that Papa made. Slept pretty good last night. Smoke detector went off at like 2 o'clock in the morning. There's no smoke at all. So we had to quickly shut down that operation right there, so. We still got a little bit here until we head out. Finish drinking our coffee and cocoa. Then we'll go catch halibut. Yeah! Alrighty guys, so me and Papa are on our way to the dock right now to get all the navigation and stuff all set up, get the boat set up. And then Kevin and Uncle Ronnie are back at camp, just still getting a couple things together. There are a whole bunch of boats going out right now. It's pretty nice outside, nice clear blue skies, little to no wind. So let's hope the fishing is gonna be great, because I guess we heard some news yesterday. Some people were talking around the dock, and this is why it's good to talk around the dock, is because there's a whole bunch of long lining boats out there that went to a couple of our spots and just totally long lined the heck out of it. Like one boat caught 400 halibut in one spot, so it just totally raked out the whole entire area, made fishing bad for everyone. So a lot of people are going to the same spot, which is pretty far, but.
Yeah, I'm gonna take my horse to the old town road. I'm gonna ride till I can't no more. I'm gonna take my horse through the old town road. I'm gonna ride till I can't no more.
I got the horses in the back, horse stock is attached. Head is matted black, got the bushes black to match. Riding on a horse, ha, you can whip your Porsche. I've been in the valley, you ain't been up off that porch. Now, can't nobody tell me nothing. Nobody tell me nothing. You can't tell me nothing. Riding on a tractor, lean all in my bladder. Cheated on my baby, you can go and ask me. My life is a movie, but riding in movies. Cowboy hat from Gucci.
Alright, we're all ready to go. We got the boat all set up. We got all the halibut rods. We got our spreader bars with weight and herring. Ready to go. So all I have to do is just snap it on and we're good. This is what we're sitting on today. Gotta get my life jacket on and we'll be good to go.
Thank you.
finally here at our halibut spot. There is a poop load of boats here. So we got boats up there, over there, all around us. Hold on, let me spin around. We got more boats over there. Ready to get fishing here. My papa has a couple coordinates where he caught halibut last year. Where we're gonna try first. We got our halibut rods with, how much weight's on there?
3 pounds.
3 pounds of weight. With herring for bait. Nice and sunny outside though.
Hung up together.
His line straight down.
I'm a thousand miles from nowhere. There's no place I'd rather be.
Floundering around. Get it, floundering?
You got one?
Yeah, he's on there. That's what that's for.
First one in the boat.
That was, that one's for. You busted your hook. Got another hook inside.
Nice fish.
I'm zoned in now.
Got one on over.
there. Hold up the air. Cool. Okay. So get over this way. Yep. Okay, go. Take one around.
Bobby, you need the pliers?
It's more like Kevin's bit. Down there.
Sebastian hooked up.
Well, that's what we're gonna have to do here. Come on. Get off of there. You can throw some more of them down.
Alright, there's our two first fish of the day with the first pass. That big one right there is Kevin's. That one's Uncle Ronnie's. Both good size. Both awesome fish. Everyone's hooking up around us. That boat got one. That boat has one. That boat has one. That boat has one. Woo! That's gonna be a good day.
Yeah, that's cool. I don't have to sit in there. I'm not an invalid. I'm just...
All right, my fishy friends. We have our limit of halibut. We got the butts in the back. Some pretty nice sized ones too. I got my first halibut. Oh my gosh! It's one per person. This big guy was the one that we just caught. We got three more in there. We got halibut! Woo! Alright, now we are on our way to do some lingcod fishing and some sea bass fishing. Oh man, that was fast. How long did that take?
We got here about 8:30 to 9:30 now. That was really good.
Hour?
Maybe.
An hour to catch those four halibut.
Probably 45 minutes by the time we got to Neah Bay.
That's pretty amazing. That's why you go to Neah Bay. To catch halibut. Off we go! I'm trying not to fall over. Took a nice little boat ride to our next location. We are lingcod and sea bass fishing. Right over here, this is Umatilla Rock. Umatilla Reef. We had one little school of fish that kind of went by, but didn't get it. So we're setting her back up for another trip pass. Changing area, so super wavy here. Let's see if we can get them. All right, we're out here lingcod fishing. Got this little tiny guy right here, a little too small. I'm gonna throw him back. Bye bye, buddy. Papa's hooked up. Let's see what it is.
Bass.
Yeah.
That's okay.
He's a big
one. It's a sea bass.
Hey, it's a giant bass
there. Yeah, I'm not sure which way who's going where, so.
Thank you.
I'm not sure if I got it on camera or not, but I just caught like a, which right now is a good size link cod.
Might be a link.
There's a tail that's right there. That's my link cod right there. Nice little guy, and then got about 13 or 14 sea bass right now. So we just got done with our limit of sea bass, halibut, and link cod session. It's absolutely amazing. Whole bunch of crazy action. Look at this. Look at this on the floor. That is a limit of sea bass, and we got a little greenling. Two little greenling, actually. Those two guys right there. And then this guy right here. I caught, which is the biggest sea bass of the day and of the trip so far. That thing's absolutely humongous. And we got our link cod and halibut down there. Out here on the water filleting it. Yes! It's gonna be yummy! They were before when you're catching them?
Yeah, they're all huge like this.
Yeah, I'm gonna take my horse to the old town road. I'm gonna ride till I can't no more. I'm gonna take my till I can't no more.
I got the horses in the bag, horse stock is attached. Head is matted black, got the bushes black to match. Riding on a horse, ha, you can look your horse. I've been in the valley, you ain't been up off that porch. Now, can't nobody tell me.